This is the SAP Developer News for February 15th, 2024.
As you may know, the developer advocates are running another developer challenge this month, and this time it's all about CAP plugins, which are great. So this week sees the second task in the challenge, which introduces another CAP plugin, this time for GraphQL. Now, while many of you already realize that CAP is absolutely awesome for rapidly building OData services and much more, CAP itself is actually a lot more protocol and database agnostic than you might think. So yes, if GraphQL is your bag, then this plugin that you're going to be learning about on this task is for you. Anyway, if you haven't already completed task one of this developer challenge, well, first of all, why not? But second of all, just head back with the link, complete task one, then come back and do this task, task two on the CAP plugin for GraphQL. It's fun and you learn stuff. What's not to like?
Did you know that the HANA CLI has a command to list information about all your HANA cloud instances? It contains information like memory sizing and quick links to help you navigate to the cockpit, HANA Cloud Central, or the Database Explorer.
Hey everyone, you probably have heard of Release Navigator for SAP Business Technology Platform. If you want to get consolidated release information across SAP BTP products and services, then bookmark this page. Not just that, you can find blog posts, newsletters, videos, podcasts, and more helpful content. Let me highlight some of the latest features. Firstly, based on your feedback, there is another way to access Release Navigator from SAP Support Portal. Click on Offerings and Programs and select Release Ready. Second, you can find the quarterly maintenance window according to the latest releases for the products featured. Additionally, some improvements in the usability. You can get to the product pages with less clicks now due to a simplified navigation on the homepage of the Release Navigator. And lastly, Release Navigator is created using SAP Enable Now, in which you can translate all text on the Navigator pages automatically to 40 languages. The upcoming updates for the Release Navigator are scheduled on a quarterly basis in alignment with the harmonized release calendar for SAP Cloud products. You can refer to the blog post by Chris for further information and provide your feedback. Thank you.
Howdy, developers. We're 4 weeks into the SAP Developer Insights survey. We've started to look at the data and we're seeing some interesting signals there, but we're not finished. If you haven't taken the survey yet, please click on the link below and give us your feedback. If you started the survey but somehow got distracted, you can click on the same link and pick up where you left off. More samples help us have a better confidence in the data that we're actually seeing, so every little bit helps. People tell us it takes about 10 minutes to complete the survey, so it shouldn't be too much of your time. We appreciate your help, and we will be back in about 2 weeks after the end of the survey on March 1st to give you an external report on what we're seeing. See you then.
Dear SAP builders, today I want to share with you highlights of some of the awesome features and announcements that were released in December 2023 and Jan 2024 in SAP Build Process Automation. First up, we have the Process Editor, which now has a vertical layout and some great usability improvements. Check out this video by Robin Kuitt, Product Manager of SAP Build Process Automation. We also have some new tutorials on this topic, so make sure to try them out. We have introduced a new governance capability called Environments. Environments provide a virtual space where you can deploy and run projects with an ability to create different shared environments. If you are curious to learn how to use this new capability, head over to this help portal page. In December 2023, we added 19 new content packages. These packages are tailored for different lines of businesses, such as finance, procurement, IT, sales, and more. To see all the available packages, I recommend you exploring SAP Build in the SAP Accelerator Hub. There is now a new enhanced recorder in Desktop Agent 3 with various options providing more control over the recording process with an user-friendly experience to manage your automation activities. Another exciting addition is the Run Now action for event triggers. This feature enables you to test your end-to-end processes locally with expected payload format without having to connect to multiple systems. And here is some great news for those who love customization. You can now build API actions from scratch using the Action Editor without relying on existing templates. It is super easy to use. Just follow the steps mentioned in this blog post by our product expert Jesse. If you have any feedback on these enhancements, please let us know in the comments of this blog post. Happy automating!